Due in part to its simplicity and to the crowd-pleasing nature of the flame and woosh that give the demonstration its name, the methanol woosh bottle has exploded in popularity in chemistry classrooms in the last 10 years or so. Exhibition Chemistry described this demonstration back in September 2009, and this month we're going to be looking at a variation that allows us to see how the energy from the reaction can be put to some good use. So you're going to need a 1 or 1.5 litre carbonated PET drinks bottle, which is going to be our rocket. Look out for the PET symbol on the bottom or a number 1 inside the recycling logo. You're also going to need about 6 mL of ethanol and a meter ruler to which you can attach a splint, and a section of guttering which is going to act as a ramp for us. Now, we've attached some cardboard to the bottom of this, but you can just prop it up on some books. About 20 degrees works just fine. We're working with ethanol here to avoid any of the accidents that have recently been coming up with methanol. It's a little bit less volatile, it's not absorbed through the skin in the way that methanol is, so it's a much safer alternative. So before you start, you're going to want to put a hole in the bottom of your bottle to act as the exhaust, about 5 mm. You can poke that through with a bradawl, or what works really nicely is to get a glass rod, hold it in a Bunsen flame, and then just pass it through the bottom of the plastic while it's still hot. Next thing you're going to want to do is to hold your finger over the end of the bottle and pour in the ethanol. Lid back on the top. Give it a good shake, so you're coating up all of the inner surfaces of the ethanol and we're getting a good fuel air mixture vaporized inside. Once you've given that a good shake, lid back off and pour out all of the excess liquid. So you want to be drawing your class's attention to the fact that there is no liquid actually remaining inside there. It's only the ethanol vapors that we're interested in, and of course the oxygen. Now, before performing the demonstration, the first thing you need to do is to dispose of the excess ethanol. That can be done down the sink with plenty of water. Many of the accidents that are happening at the moment with the methanol woosh bottle are to do with the fact that a little bit too much methanol is being used, and also potentially that the excess methanol is being kept too close to the demonstration while it's happening. So make sure you dispose of that. The bottle will last for a decent while before you need to light it. When ready to go, if you leave the bottle at the bottom of the ramp, protect audience and demonstrator with a safety screen, and light with the end of a splint. Let's let it go.